Welcome to our channel Learn Easy Assam. Today's video we will discuss about the ray optics and optical instruments. In our last video we have discussed about reflection and refraction of light, spherical mirrors, sign convention, relation between F and R, mirror formula we have derived, and we have also discussed about magnification. In this video we are going to discuss about refractive index. So let's start. In order to understand refractive index, if you can remember laws of refraction, then you can see here the diagram. The first law says that the incident ray, refracted ray and the normal to the interface at the point of incidence. This is the point of incidence. So point of incidence lie in the same plane. So this plane, I have already discussed about this. So this plane is the plane where the incident ray, the normal and the refracted ray fall on. And second law of refraction is that the ratio of the sine of the angle. So we have to recall all these things. The ratio of the sine of the angle of incidence to the sine of the angle of refraction. So the sine of angle of incidence and sine of angle of refraction, if you do the ratio, if you divide, then you will get a constant for two media. You will get a constant. So you will get a constant, or you can say here the constant is called the refractive index. So the constant is called refractive index, that is relative refractive index. Why? Because we are comparing two medium, so the refractive index will be with respect to each other. That is why we are calling it as relative refractive index of medium 2 with respect to medium 1, and denoted by, so you can see here, sin I by sin R is equal to n 2 1. So you have to write 2 1 in this manner. Then if you write n, you can see here n 2 1. What does it mean? It means that the refractive index of medium 2. So if refractive index of medium 2, that means this medium, medium 2 with respect to medium 1. So now if we switch the medium 1 to medium 2, then what will happen? We have to write here, it will be medium 2 and it will be medium 1. Then we can write n as refractive index as n 1 2. What we will call this refractive index of medium 1 with respect to 2. So that means if you say in this manner, then we have to understand that the light is coming from medium 2 to medium 1 in this case. Or if we say that n 2 1, then we will understand that light is coming from medium 1 to medium 2, and this law is called Snell's law. If you can recall, then you will understand it. Now let us discuss about the refractive index. We have already discussed our refractive index from this ratio, but you can see that it will be difficult for us to find the angle between the normal and the incident ray, or the normal and the refracted ray, because in physically it will be very tedious to do or to find the angle. But we can do, or we can find the refractive index of the medium in some other way. So let us see the other way. So you see, it is associated with the velocity of light. It is associated with the velocity of light. Velocity of light in vacuum. In vacuum, and velocity of light in medium. So we know that the velocity of light in vacuum and velocity of light in different medium is different. So if we compare these two velocities in some mathematical way, then we can get the refractive index. So it will be easy to find the refractive index of a medium without calculating or without measuring the angle of incidence or angle of refraction. So if you consider the refractive index for a medium with respect to vacuum, then we can write refractive index, we can write Ri, or we can say n, that is equal to what it will be. It will be refractive index, it will be the velocity of light in vacuum. Velocity of light in vacuum we used to write as c, and velocity of light in medium we can say v. So what it will be, refractive index of that medium will be C by V. So this is the ratio between the velocity of light in vacuum and the velocity of light in the medium. So from this we will understand that refractive index of medium with respect to vacuum. So if any medium has the refractive index which is with respect to vacuum, then we call this refractive index as absolute refractive index. So absolute refractive index. Now we can compare any refractive index. Suppose if you consider n1 as the refractive index of a medium with velocity where the light velocity of light is v1, and another is there where we can write n2, and it is the its refractive index will be c by v2. So we can now, from the absolute refractive index, we can also find the relative refractive index. So if you divide these two, what you will get, you can see from this, if you see here, from this, if we divide these two, we can write C by V1 into V2 by C. If we write in this manner, then C will get cancelled. Then we will get this part, this C by V1 is nothing but N1, and this part is nothing but N2. So this is 1 by N2, that means 1 by N2. So it will be N1 by N2, and it will be V2 here, and it will be V1. So we can write it is 2 and it is 1. So this is the refractive index of medium 1. Okay, we have to write this n 1 2. So this is the refractive index of medium 1 with respect to medium 2. In this manner we have to write this. Now we can see here about the optical density. First we can see that what is optical density. Before optical density, we know that when light goes from rare medium to denser medium, then it bends towards the normal. So if you can see here, this is the interface, and if light goes from, suppose this is the normal, so this is the normal, we can draw here, this is the normal, and if light goes from, this is the rarer medium, suppose this is rarer medium and this is denser medium, then at the point of interface between the normal and the incident ray, what will happen? The light will bend. It will bend towards the normal. So depending on the density of the medium, the bending will take place. So if it is more denser, then it will be more bending towards the normal. So here the denser means it is the density of the medium is not equal to density is not equal to the density of the mass, or we can say mass density. So if you can remember that mass density, we know that mass density is nothing but mass per unit volume, but here it is not mass density, it is called optical density. It is something associated with light. So it is not equivalent to the mass density. So optical density is nothing. You can say that it is the ratio of speed of light into media. So you can write that it is the ratio of the speed of light into media. So it will give us the optical density. If we say that it is rarer medium and it is denser medium in context of light, then we will understand that this denser medium is, they are calling about optical density, not the mass density. So we can see, for example, turpentine is less denser in terms of mass. So mass density of turpentine is less than that of the water, but its optical density is higher. So we can say that turpentine, so if you give the example, you can write that turpentine's mass density mass density. Mass density is less as compared to water's mass density. Water mass density. But turpentine's optical density is greater than the water's optical density. So we can see here optical density is higher, so optical density of turpentine is higher as compared to water, whereas the mass density is less, whereas the mass density of turpentine is less than the water. So it is the comparison of optical density and mass density. Hope you have understood optical density. Now let us see the reversibility principle of light. So you can understand from this word reversibility, it is reverse. Reverse means if you are going in this direction, then if you want to reverse the direction, then what will happen? You have to come back through the same path but in opposite direction. So light also follows this principle, this manner. So what happens if we say in this position, this is the medium 1 and this is medium 2, this is medium 1 and this is medium 2, if we say, and this is normal. So if you draw it in this manner, then what will happen? Light will come here and it will refract in this manner. Now if we draw a mirror here, then what will happen? From this, light may also go back or trace back the same path. Then we will say that the light is reversing back its original path. So that means light follows the principle of reversibility. So that is the concept. So you can find this by writing mathematically as refractive index of 1, medium 1 with respect to medium 2 must be equal to 1 by refractive index of medium 2 with respect to medium 1. Then you will understand that the light follows the principle of reversibility. So it is very easy, we can do it. So if you see here in this diagram, we can say that this is the angle of incidence I and this is the angle of reflection R, and this point, at this point you can say this is A. This is A. Now what will happen? We can write from the Snell's law. So we can write from Snell's law. What you can write? We can write that N21 is nothing but sin I by sin R. We know that. Now again, if you want to write sin N12, then let us consider a mirror is kept here. So if you could put a mirror here, then what will happen? In this case, we can write, after putting the mirror, we can write N12, because light is now going from this medium 2 to medium 1. So we can write N12 and it will be sine. Here you can see this angle is the, this R angle now become, after putting the mirror, the R angle will be angle of incidence for medium 2. So we can write angle R, this is the angle of incidence, and sine, here we can write sine I, this is the angle of reflection. Now you can see here, after reversing back the same path, then this angle will be the angle of reflection from medium 2 to medium 1. So we can write here, this is equation number 2 and this is equation number 1. So we can see here that equation number 1 and 2, if we multiply equation number 1 multiplied by equation number 2, then what we will get? We will get N, we will get N21 multiplied by N12, it is nothing but sin I by sin R multiplied by sin R by, this is this part, sin I R by sin I. So you can see here this part and this part will get cancelled, and this part and this part will get cancelled, and we will get 1. So from this we can write, which implies that n 1 2 is equal to 1 by n 2 1. So we have got this value for the principle of reversibility. So this is the, if you want to show the principle that light is following the principle of reversibility, then we have to show this only, and then we will understand that light follows the principle of reversibility. So there are some examples for showing the principle of reversibility. Some applications will be there. For example, the refraction of light through a rectangular slab. So if there is a rectangular slab like this, then light will follow a path in this manner. So we can understand how light follows from one medium to another medium, or from air to the glass medium, here in this video, in this part. Okay, then we can also understand the apparent depth and normal shift. So I will teach this in the last video sessions, where we will discuss about the examples and applications part of the whole lesson, and we will also get all the notes of the videos, last video session of this lesson. So I request you to stay tuned by subscribing it, and don't forget to click the bell icon so that you will get my videos one by one, and you will get the notification whenever I upload my video. So thank you for watching. Hello learners, you can watch the previous videos and lessons just by clicking here or here. So what are you waiting for? Learning is easy and is free here.